Holy Spirit, we bless your name. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have the victory. Father, we bless your name this morning. What an awesome day that you have made. Thank you, Father, for defeating all our enemies. Thank you for giving us new song. Thank you for bringing us even to the fourth Sunday in the year 2020, the beginning of another era, the beginning of another decade. Thank you for signs and wonders. We are expectant. Thank you for bringing us to a year of double. Lord, as we go into your word, we ask, oh Lord, you will send your word unto us. Let your word come with power. Let it come with understanding. And we vow that at the end of the day, Father, all the glory will be given to you, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have given time.
Amen.
And the people of God will say a loud amen.
Amen.
A louder amen.
Amen.
Welcome three people and tell them you are welcome to 2020. Your year of double. Go around, welcome three people. You are welcome to 2020, your year of double. The Lord. I'm not sure you're happy to be in church this morning. Maybe they drag you to church. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you happy to be in your father's house? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Ask your neighbor, are you happy to be in church this morning?
Has
God been good to you and your family?
Has God been good to you and your family?
Hallelujah. No, ask your neighbor, has God been good to you and your family?
Has God been good to you and your family?
Yes, he has been good. Then give him a clap offering. Give Jesus a big clap
offering.
Clap offering. You can do better. Thank you, Jesus. Now give Jesus a shout of praise. Father, we thank you. Once again, I want to say Happy New Year to every one of us in Jesus' name. And today is spectacular. Tell your neighbor, today is spectacular.
Today is spectacular.
In my life,
in my life,
in this church,
in this church,
in this community,
in this community,
in this nation, and in this family of God. Now, why is today spectacular? Today is our fourth day that we'll be starting our two service. Give Jesus a big round of applause. Give him a big round of applause. Today is spectacular, the beginning of a year of double, the beginning of signs and wonder, the beginning of miracles, the beginning of mighty things to come. If you are clapping for Jesus, clapping, Father. We bless your name. Praise the Lord. How many of us are expectant this morning? Expectant of what God will do in my life, and God will visit you this morning. Tell yourself, God will visit me this morning. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! On Christmas Day, the Lord brought His word to us on my season of double. For as many of us that were here, and so we are going to be building on that. And you see, this year, what you hear is very important. What you decide to pay your attention to is very important. And one thing that God wants you to pay strong attention to in this year is His word. As you pay attention to the word of God, your double will begin to manifest.
Amen.
I say your double will begin to manifest.
Amen.
I say your double will begin to manifest.
Amen.
I say your double will begin to manifest.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm beginning to enjoy double already.
Yeah.
I'm beginning to express double. As a family, we are beginning to express double. God paid off a financial debt in this January. This is not about, the Bible is not a storybook, it's not a novel. This is the word of God. we prove it, not to prove it for yourself. It works. Tell your neighbor, the word of God works.
The word of God works.
2 Kings chapter 7. And we are going to read from verse 1 to 20.
Then Elisha said,
Thank you, sir. We are going to read together. Every one of us, we are going to read together. Make sure you pay attention to the word of God. To command double, you need to pay attention to what God has to say to you. 1, 2, go. Then Elisha said, hear ye the word of the Lord, thus says the Lord. Tomorrow, about this time, shall a measure of fine flour be sold for a shekel, and 2 measures of barley for a shekel, and in the gates of Samaria. Then the Lord, on whose hand the king lay, answered the man of God and said, behold, the Lord will make windows in heaven, might this be? And he said, behold, thou shalt see with thy eyes, but thou shalt not endure. And there were 4 leprous men at entering in of the gate. And they said one to another, why sit we here until we die? If we say we will enter into the city, then the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit still here, we die also. Now therefore come, let us fall into the host of the Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall but die. And they rose up in the twilight to go up to the camp of the Syrians. And when they were come to the uttermost part of the camp of Syria, behold, there was no man there. For the Lord had made the host of Syria to hear a noise of chariots and a noise of horses, even the noise of a great host. And they said one to another, lo, the king of Israel had hired against us the king of the Hittites and the king of the Egyptians to come upon us. The camp of your enemy will hear his ring now. The camp of your enemy will hear his ring now. Because they need to hear that ring now so that your double can come. Verse 7, 1 to go. Wherefore they rose and fled in the twilight and left their tents and their horses and their asses, even the camp as it was, and fled for their lives. And when this leper came to the uttermost part of the camp, they went into one tent and did eat and drink and carried them silvers and gold and raiment and went and hid it and came again and entered into another tent and carried them also and went and hid it. Then they said one to another, we do not well. This day is a day of good tidings. Tell your neighbor, this day is a day of good tidings.
This day is my day of good tidings.
Now let's continue. And we hold our peace. If we tarry till the morning light, some mischief will come upon us. Now therefore come, that we may go and tell the king's household. So they came and called unto the porter of the city. And they told them, saying, we came to the camp of the Syrians, and behold, there was no man there, neither boys of man, but horses tied, and asses tied, and the tents as they were. And they called the porters, and they told it to the king's house within. And the king arose in the night, and said unto his servants, I will now show you what the Syrians have done to us. They know that we be hungry. Therefore are they gone out of the camp to hide themselves in the field, saying, when they come out of the city, we shall catch them alive and get into the city. Your enemies will not catch you.
Amen.
I say your enemies will not catch you.
Amen.
Verse 13 together. And one of his servants answered and said, let some take, I pray thee, 5 of the horses that remain, which are left in the city. Behold, they are as all the multitude of Israel that are left in it. Behold, I say, they are even as all the multitude of Israel. that are consumed. Let us send and see. Then they took therefore two chariot horses, and the king sent after the host of the Syrians, saying, go and see. That is what you are going to tell your neighbor. Your neighbors in your community, tell them, come and see. That's what we're going to tell the youth. Come and see. That's what we're going to tell the Syrian refugees, that there is peace in the Lord. It doesn't matter what trauma they are facing in their country, in this land they will prosper.
Amen.
So that is what we're going to tell our neighbors. Come and see. Verse 15 together. And they went after them unto Jordan. And lo, all the way was full of garments and vessels, which the Syrians had cast away in their haste. And the messengers returned and told the king. And the people went out and spoiled the tent of the Syrians. So a measure of fine flour was sold for a shekel, and two barley for a shekel, according to the word of the Lord. And the king appointed the Lord on whose hand he leaned to have the charge of the gate. And the people trod upon him in the gate, and he died, as the man of God has said, who spake when the king came down to him. Verse 18. And it came to pass, as the man of God had spoken to the king, saying, two measures of barley for a shekel, and a measure of fine flour for a shekel, shall be tomorrow, about this time, at the gate of Samaria. And that the Lord answered the man of God, and said, now, behold, if the Lord should make windows in heaven, might such a thing be? And he said, behold, thou seest it with thy eyes, but shall not eat thereof. Verse 20, the last verse. And so it fell out unto him, for the people trod upon him in the gate, and he died. I want you to bow down your head. It is dangerous not to believe the word of God. The man of God told him that you will see, but you will not eat thereof. I want you to pray and say, Lord, I believe your word. Be it unto me according to your word. Go ahead and make that your prayer. Bow down your head and pray. It's your year of double. Do you really believe it? Has it entered your subconscious mind? Is it in your spirit already? Is it in your blood already? Say, Lord, I believe you. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So again, we are looking at entering your season of double. And one of the things that the Lord brought our way on Christmas Day is that there are different seasons. There is winter, there is spring, there is summer, there is fall. And each of these seasons, they reveal certain things. One of the things that it reveals is that it reveals the end of a particular season, and it also ushers in a new season. One of the things that the Lord brought our way on that day is that seasons are usually unveiled through signs. That for you to enter your season of double, then there are some signs that the Lord will begin to show you. A good example was this case. Now we all know that the Syrians have always been an enemy of God, the enemy of the people of God. And interestingly, as God will have it, God sent a servant to declare his word unto the people. Because people were beginning to eat themselves, if you read in chapter 6. So things were so terrible. I pray for you, it doesn't matter how things was terrible for you last year. This year is your year of double.
Amen.
I say it's your year of double.
Amen.
Say, Lord, I believe it.
Lord,
be it unto me according to your word. So the Syrian army, they besieged the land of Samaria. So things were tough. Things were difficult. But then, in the midst of that famine, in the midst of that problem, God sent the servant to declare that by this time tomorrow, your story will have changed.
Amen.
God will put a new song in your mouth.
Amen.
I said, God will put a new song in your mouth.
Amen.
By this time tomorrow, he said, 5 flour be sold for a shekel and 2 measures of barley for a shekel in the gate of Samaria. By this time tomorrow. By this time tomorrow. So, one of the signs that you are going to notice for you to begin to enter your season of double is that there's going to be the word of God will be released. God will oftentimes send his word forth. That's why the Bible tells us that he sent forth his word and his word healed them. So for you to enter your season of double, the word of God has to come. And you see where the word of God is coming. Some people are very busy. Busy with other things. I pray that you will not miss the word that is meant for you.
Amen.
I say you will not miss the word that is meant for you.
Amen.
Strange things will begin to happen that will bring in your year of double. Amen. Look at the lepers. Who could imagine that God could bring that word to pass? True lepers. Dejected people. Abandoned people. Nobody wanted to do anything with lepers. They smell. They put them in there, you know, outside of the nation, where people cannot have relationship with them. But could you see that for God to perform his work, he had prepared a strange way. And that is where faith comes in. That's why as children of God, don't walk by sight, walk by faith. If you walk by sight, there's no way you can command double. If you walk by your senses, there's no way you can command double. And no wonder even the king did not even believe it. The one, the servant who said in verse 2, himself did not believe it. Because they were walking by sight. I say, in this year, you will command double.
Amen.
As a church, evangelism, why we will command double.
Amen.
Now, so what does double mean? Double simply means enlargement. Double simply means multiplication. In this year, God will enlarge you.
Amen.
I say, God will enlarge you.
Amen.
In this year, God will enlarge me.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, in this year, God will enlarge you.
In this year, God will enlarge you.
In this year, you will multiply.
In this year, you multiply.
On every side.
On every side.
Praise the Lord. Genesis chapter 1. Verse 28. And God bless them. May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
I say, may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
And God said unto them, on the Coconut Parish, and God said unto them, we are the them. Be fruitful, more than Coconut Parish, be fruitful.
Amen.
I declare upon you, be fruitful.
Amen.
Your marriage be fruitful.
Amen.
Your career be fruitful.
Amen.
The church of God will be fruitful.
Amen.
And multiply.
Amen.
And replenish the earth.
Amen.
And subdue it.
Amen.
And have dominion.
Amen.
Let's pause there. So double simply means dominion as well. Maybe, you know, one day I was listening to a man of God. And, you know, he spoke a word, and that word unveiled some things. It's like something just opened in my ear. And I said in my spirit, I said, if this man is in Nigeria and he commands things like this, I said, I'm here, I will command things like that. And I said it.
Amen.
And things begin to happen. So, year 2020 is your year of dominion. He said, over the fish, over the sea, or of the sea, and over the fowls of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. If you visited the hospital last year, that will be the last time you will visit.
Yeah.
Why? It's your year of double.
Amen.
Why? It's your year of fruitfulness.
Amen.
What is fruitfulness when there were people are sick? You remember the story of the Israelites? When they were in Egypt, they were increasing in number, but yet they were still under bondage. I pray for you. I say, in this year, you'll be fruitful.
Amen.
You will multiply.
Amen.
You will replenish the earth.
Amen.
You will subdue it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So if you want to define what double is, it's in Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. Now let's move on. Now there are different types of seasons. There are different types of seasons all over the world. Number one, there's what we call the season of restoration, and that is the testimony of somebody here.
Yeah.
That is my testimony.
Amen.
That is the testimony of the church.
Amen.
12 chapter 2. We are in a season of restoration. The church of God is in the season of restoration. Entering your season of double. Joel 2, somebody should read from verse 25.
And I will restore to you.
Amen.
Amen. The years that the locusts have eaten.
Amen.
The caterpillar.
Amen.
The caterpillar.
Amen.
The palm worm.
Amen.
You see, don't say, you see, don't just say, if you don't believe me, don't say amen. You see, just make sure that you are, that amen is from your heart. Start again, sir.
And I restore to you.
Amen.
The years that locusts has eaten.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Army which I sent among you.
Amen.
And you shall eat in plenty.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And be satisfied.
Amen.
And praise the name of the Lord your God.
Now that means when God has increased you in 2020, what are you to do?
Praise the name of the Lord.
Let's say it louder.
Praise the name of the Lord.
That is not the time to tell brothers in Nigeria. I preach people who have said, I'm sorry, I have shit this morning. I can't come to church. That is not the time that you begin to use BB grammar for God. When the Lord has blessed you, you praise the name of the Lord your God. Go ahead, sir.
That dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed.
Amen. So, number one, type of seasons. Season of restoration. So, when God said it is your season of double, it is the season where God will be restoring everything that you have lost in the past.
Amen.
God will restore everything that you have lost to the enemy.
Amen.
Number two, there's also what we call the season of abundance. It is in Genesis chapter 41. Genesis chapter 41. Genesis 41 from verse 46.
And Joseph was 30 years old.
Joseph was 30 years old.
When he stood before Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
Say, I want you to stand up on your feet and tell three people. You are not too young to stand before the president.
You are not too young to stand before the president.
You are not too young to stand before the president. You are not too young to stand before the president. You are not too young. Please sit down. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Genesis 41, verse 46.
And Joseph was 30 years old.
Joseph was 30 years old.
When he stood before Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
And Joseph went out from the presence of Pharaoh.
Uh-huh.
And went throughout all the land of Egypt.
Okay.
And in the seven plenteous years.
In the seven plenteous years. This is your year of plenty.
Yeah.
This is your year of plenty.
Yeah.
Go ahead, sir.
By handful,
uh-huh.
And he gathered up all the food of the 7 years,
uh-huh.
Which were in the land of Egypt,
okay.
And laid all the food in the cities,
okay.
Food of the field,
uh-huh.
Which was round about every city,
okay.
Laid it up in the same,
uh-huh.
And Joseph gathered corn as the sand of the sea.
Look at it, he gathered corn as the sand of the sea because it's the season of abundance. That will be your testimony.
Amen.
Amen.
Very much.
Very much.
Until he left numbering.
Until he cannot even count them anymore.
For it was without number.
For it was without number. That will be your testimony.
Amen.
Number three, types of season. Number one is season of restoration. Number two, season of abundance. Number three, season of joy. Say, this is my season of joy.
This is my season of joy.
Say it as if this is my season of joy. Remember how the Lord started with us this morning? Just believe. Don't look at the circumstances and just believe. You might say, he doesn't know what I'm going through. Don't worry about what you're going through. Believe the word of God. If you can change that situation, wouldn't you have changed it? You will have changed it for a long time. So believe me. Say again, tell it to yourself, this is my season of joy.
This is my season of joy.
I am in my season of joy.
I am in my season of joy.
Praise the Lord. Now, the book of Psalms, chapter 30. Verse 5 said, for his anger endure for a moment. But a moment. Maybe you are here, your family, yourself. The Lord was angry with you before. Maybe for one sin or the other that you have committed. See what is going to happen to your life next. In his favor, is life. When a man finds God's favor, he finds life. And that life is Jesus Christ. Now maybe you have wept before. He said, weeping may endure for a night. But joy comes in the morning. When is your own joy? Say this morning.
Now.
Season of joy. There's also the season of increase and growth. That's number 4. Acts chapter 2, verse 47. Acts chapter 2, verse 47.
Praising God.
And having favor with all the people.
And the Lord added to the church daily.
How many? Daily. More than conqueror pride. That will be the testimony.
Amen.
I said that will be the order of things in more than conqueror pride.
Amen.
Is it weekly?
No.
Monthly?
No,
biannually?
No,
or yearly? Daily, God will add to more than conqueror party.
Yeah.
Go ahead, sir.
Such as should be saved.
There are some people that should be saved. We will find them.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit will bring them.
Amen.
God added to the church daily. The church needs to grow daily. Any church that is not growing daily, then Jesus is not in that church. Because he is not a stagnant God. The church grows daily. In strength, the church will grow.
Amen.
In wisdom, we will grow.
Amen.
In holiness, we will grow.
Amen.
In righteousness, we will grow.
Amen.
In prosperity, we will grow.
Amen.
Say, Lord, I believe in.
Lord, I believe in.
Now, as we prepare to enter our seasons, the season that we are in, it's like entering the gate of Samaria. There was hopelessness. This is the beginning of the year for you and your family. This is the beginning of double. This is the beginning of changes. There are some things which are like keys that will unlock this season. We talked about one of them on Christmas Day. Obedience. Let's say obedience.
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 So one of such important key that will unlock your season, that will bring you in, is obedience. Obedience to the word of God. Obedience, simply put, is to act with immediate effect on God's instruction. God said, go, go. God said, apply for that job. Apply. God said, fast, fast. Obedience. You must be prompt about it. Obedience. Now, when you obey God, naturally, you begin to enjoy abundance. Double begin to come your way. Job chapter 36. Job 36. Verse 11. If they obey and serve him. If they obey and serve him. Tell your neighbor, obey the Lord. And serve the Lord.
Obey the Lord.
And serve the Lord. They shall spend their day in prosperity. The Bible did not say they shall spend their days in sickness. The Bible did not say they will spend their days in sorrow. It did not say they will spend their day in penury, in lack, in shame. No, it said in prosperity. Not just material prosperity, spiritual prosperity. Prosperity on all around. And their years in pleasure. That will be your testimony.
Amen.
I said that will be your testimony.
Amen.
But you need to obey God. So even if you say, well, you don't even want to be prosperous, it's too late. For as long as you obey God, you'll be prosperous.
Amen.
Then you obey Him and you serve Him. Now, let's move to key number two. Because this one, the key of obedience, we've looked at that. Now, let's look at the key of revelation. How do you enter into your season of double? There's some keys. Number two, the key of revelation. Let's look at Genesis. Genesis chapter 30. Genesis chapter 30. And let's look at from verse 32.
I will pass through all the flock today.
Okay.
Moving from thence all the speckled and spotted cattle. And all the brown cattle among the sheep.
Okay.
And the spotted and the speckled among the goats. And of Saul shall be my hire.
God will make you wise.
Amen.
I say, God will make you wise.
Amen.
God will make me wise.
Amen.
Jacob was a very wise man. A very wise and cunning man. But be a wise man. Don't be a cunning man.
Amen.
Yes. Verse 33.
So shall my righteousness answer for me in time to come. When shall come for me? When shall come for my hire before my that face? Everyone that is not speckled, and spotted among the goats, and brown among the sheep, that shall be counted stolen with me. And Laban said, behold, I will eat my bee according to thy word. And he removed that day the e-goats that were ripped straight and spotted, and all the she-goats that were speckled and spotted, and everyone that had some white in it, and all the brown among the sheep, and gave them into the hand of his sons. And he set 3 days journey with himself and Jacob. And Jacob fed the rest of Laban's flocks.
Thank you, sir. Now jump to verse 43.
And the man increased exceedingly.
You will increase exceedingly.
Yeah.
I will increase exceedingly.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
And had much cattle.
And had much cattle.
And many maid servants.
And maid servants.
And men servants.
And men servants.
And camels.
And camels.
And
and horses. In the order of Jacob, God will open your eyes.
Amen.
You see, the question you should ask yourself is, was Jacob an agriculturalist?
No.
No. In fact, if you read the next chapter, when he was talking to his wife, he said something. He said, an angel revealed them to me. So the double that you are going to command in this year, God needs to open your eyes to see some secret. There are insights that you need to see. It's just like when they put you in the midst of, let's say maybe 1,000 he-goats, and they ask you to choose. Which one will you choose? You will choose the right one. This man had the wisdom and the insight on what he needed to do in your place of work. God will show you what you needed to do.
Amen.
I said in your career, God will show you what you needed to do.
Amen.
What will make you outstanding, God will show it to you.
Amen.
The side that will make you outstanding, that will make you to praise God, God will show it to you.
Amen.
So you need the key of revelation. Divine insight. It's not available to everybody. Only few people have access to it. And that's why you see some people, when they lay their hand on some things, they prosper. It is inside. When you tell them to do something, you see the way they do it marvelously. It is inside. Every believer, if you must enter your season of double, you need that revelation. I want you to bow down your head and pray. I want you to say, Father,
whatever it will take,
to open my eyes, to behold secrets. that will bring me and my household and your church to our season of double. Please open our eyes to see them. Open our eyes. Go ahead and make that your prayer. Jacob testified. An angel revealed them to him. An angel told him, put this one here, and then you will have your own flocks. That business, you need the Lord to open your eyes. Maybe as you are betting, an idea just drop in your mind. As you are sleeping something, just open your eyes. As you are walking on the street, something just speak to your ear. The angel of the Lord just fly by and just speak something into your ear. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
We know the story in the book of Luke. How Jesus Christ, after he had resurrected, and some of his disciples were walking on the street on the way to Emmaus. And when they were walking, they were arguing within themselves. They didn't even know that Jesus Christ that they were talking about was actually with them. The same way with us as believers, you have Jesus living inside of you. Jesus lives in your tabernacle. He lives in your body. He lives in your home. He lives in your car. Anywhere you appear, Jesus appears there. But Jesus had to open your eyes. I pray for you. God will open your eyes.
Amen.
I say, God will open your eyes.
Amen.
God will open your eyes.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Rise up on your feet. Season of restoration. Season of abundance. Season of joy. You are going to declare and lift up to your two hands. You are going to say, in this year.
In this year.
Please pray for yourself. You are going to say, in this year.
In this year.
In this year.
In this year.
I am entering my season of restoration. Now go ahead and begin to pray everything that you have lost in the time past. This is the time to take it. This is the time to take it. This is the time to take it. Are you here this morning? And you are here to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Every your season of trouble could be trouble when you don't have Jesus. But when you have Jesus, He brings you to your season of trouble. The rest of you pray. If you are here this morning and you want to make Jesus your Lord, come forward as you pray with me. The Lord, whatever thing you have lost, God is able to restore them back to you. You want to say, Jesus, I want to begin the year with you. Please come forward. Please come forward. Come forward. Come forward. Jesus is waiting for you. He died so that you might enjoy trouble. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Prayer number two. You are going to say,
Father,
in this year of trouble, let me begin to command abundance in all areas of my life. I will enjoy prosperity. I will enjoy good health. And I will praise your name. Go ahead and make that your prayer. Make that your prayer. Make it 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 your prayer. Student, pray, pray. Don't be like that. The king's servant.